A right triangle has one leg with a length of x meters. The other leg is 7 meters longer. The length of the hypotenuse is 8 meters longer than the shortest leg. We're asked to find the lengths of the sides of the right triangle. We'll be solving this problem using the Pythagorean theorem, which is a squared plus b squared equals c squared, where a and b are the lengths of the two legs, and c is the length of the hypotenuse. So looking at the right triangle below, the legs are the two sides that form the right angle. Let's label the length of this leg A, the length of this leg B. The hypotenuse is the longest side of the right triangle. It's also always opposite the right angle. This is the hypotenuse, which has a length of C. Now let's go back to the given information. One leg has a length of X meters. Let's label the length of this leg X meters. The length of the other leg is 7 meters longer. The length of this leg is x plus 7 meters. The length of the hypotenuse is 8 meters longer than the shortest leg. The shortest leg has a length of x meters, and therefore the length of the hypotenuse is x plus 8 meters. And now we'll set up an equation using the Pythagorean theorem. A squared is the square of x, plus b squared is the square of x plus 7, equals c squared, which equals the square of x plus 8. And now for the next step, we'll multiply this out. The square of x is equal to x squared, plus, there are no shortcuts when squaring a binomial. The square of x plus 7 is equal to 2 factors of x plus 7. And the square of x plus 8 is equal to 2 factors of x plus 8. When multiplying two binomials, we always have four products, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And here, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we have x squared plus x times x is x squared, plus x times 7 is 7x, plus 7 times x is 7x, plus 7 times 7, which equals 49, so plus 49 equals x times x is x squared, plus x times 8, that's plus 8x, plus 8 times x, that's also 8x, plus 8 times 8 is 64. And now combine like terms, here we have two x squared terms, here we have two x terms on the left, and two x terms on the right. X squared plus x squared is equal to 2x squared, so we have 2x squared plus 7x plus 7x is 14x. We still have plus 49 equals on the right, x squared plus 16x plus 64. Notice how we have a quadratic equation. Let's try to solve this by factoring, and therefore we'll set one side of the equation equal to 0. Let's set the right side of the equation equal to 0 by subtracting x squared on both sides, subtracting 16x on both sides, as well as subtracting 64 on both sides. Let's go ahead and do this all in one step. On the right, we'll have minus x squared minus 16x minus 64. On the left, we'll also have minus x squared minus 16x minus 64. And now we'll simplify. On the left, 2x squared minus x squared is x squared. 14x minus 16x is negative 2x, or minus 2x. 49 minus 64 is equal to negative 15, which we'll write as minus 15 equals, on the right, x squared minus x squared is 0, 16x minus 16x is 0, and 64 minus 64 is 0. Now we'll use the shortcut method to factor the left side. If this does factor, it will factor into two binomial factors. Using the shortcut method, we're looking for two integers that have a product of c, which is negative 15, and that have a sum of b, which is negative 2. So looking at the pairs of integers that give a product of negative 15, we have negative 1 times 15, negative 15 times 1, negative 3 times 5, or negative 5 times 3. Because we need the sum to be negative 2, We're looking for the integers, negative 5 and positive 3. Again, because negative 5 times 3 equals negative 15, and negative 5 plus 3 is equal to negative 2, which means the two factors of x squared minus 2x minus 15 are x minus 5 and x plus 3. And now to solve, we use the zero product property, which tells us if this product is equal to 0, the first factor of x minus 5 must equal 0, or the second factor of x plus 3 must equal 0. Solving for x here, we add 5 to both sides and get x equals 5. Or, solving this equation for x, we subtract 3 on both sides, and we get x equals negative 3. But in this case, only one of these solutions makes sense because, remember, x is a length, and length cannot be negative. So while this would be an algebraic solution, it is not applicable in this application problem. So now we know x equals 5. We can determine the lengths of the three sides of the right triangle. The length of the short leg is x meters, and therefore this length is 5 meters. The length of the longer leg is x plus 7 meters. Again, because x is 5, 5 plus 7 is 12. So this length is 12 meters. The length of the hypotenuse is x plus 8 meters, which would be 5 plus 8, or 13 meters. I hope you found this helpful.